Hey you guys, it's great to see you and welcome to episode 1 of the Great to See You podcast, live here from the G4 podcast studios. Big shout out to Mayo Signs. They do all your signs, they do all the signage you need. Just give them a shout, they do workwear as well. Anyway, it's great to see you, and today, of all days, we have number one artist, David Evans.
David Evans?
That's it.
Why did you say fucking David Evans?
David Evans.
I checked it. Like, is that not your name?
No.
My dad's not coming.
Nice. No,
that's it, David Evans, yeah?
I said David Evans.
You
just absolutely embarrassed everybody.
Hello, everybody. It's great to see you. Because it is great to see you. Yes, we have the main man, Nathan Evans, a.k.a. the Weller Man, a.k.a. Slim Shady.
A.k.a.
Slim Shanty.
He's a big
Slim
deal.
Shanty, sorry.
Slim Shanty,
what
man.
An idiot.
Fuck's sake, Steve.
A.k.a. Slim Shanty.
Slim Shanty. We may put some beeps over this so it's child-friendly. Wait and see.
Yes.
Because we did a test run last week and we did it with all the lights out, so we get some good feedback, good patter, but it was too dark. So this is take 2, and what we're going to do for everybody is start a timer, right? We don't want to bore everybody, we're going to get right to the tits. I can't see.
Right. You can't, wait, no. Okay. What the boss, I didn't tell anything but his dash on.
Okay,
I've spent like three weeks working out what's the best, you know, what tash would suit Nathan Evans, so I went and got this moustache from Nathan, please. Show me your moustache.
Who's going to be the judge of this, right?
Oh,
it's sexy, man.
It's sexy. It's the Hulk Hogan.
It's your Hulk Hogan.
Hulk Hogan.
Right, so it's very, very good. You look fantastic.
Look good,
you look very, very good.
Shame I can't grow one last bit.
It does suit you. Oh. You're in the same boat as I can't grow.
Excuse me, I quite like my tash. It's grown on me.
Shite.
Anyway. I've got a wee bit of sound production here.
Very good.
Anyway, it's all good. So it.
Wilson, I can't control
the timer started, so...
Okay, let's go.
Right, we're ready to fucking kick ass here. Fucking booyah. Right, so... Nate Dogg, how are you?
My tash is falling off. I'm good, man. Good.
It's good fun, isn't it?
It's good.
Right,
I'm good. Life's good.
So, let's find out. Last night, you were at the Nordoff Robbins Scottish Music Awards, is that right?
Yes,
You won the award for Best Breakthrough Artist.
Yes, I did.
And how does that feel like?
Mental. Absolutely mental.
Right, give us a bit of juicy gossip. Who was there? Who did you run into?
Running, because it was in the Barrowlands. So, yeah. For anybody that's not been in the Barrowlands, the green room / changing room / dressing room, whatever you want to call it, everybody just kind of has the same one. It's a big communal one. So everybody that was there, like Wet, McDonald, Nina Nesbitt, everybody that was acting, the Bluebells, everybody was just in the one room pretty much. So
class.
Just everybody that was there. I was just
chilling
like,
out with all the fam.
The Nate Dogg walks in and says, "All right, man, I'm the Nate Dogg, I'm the main man."
I just walked in.
Get out.
That was me, I was walking in.
Just like that?
Just exactly like
when
that.
You walked in the door, that
tune played, it was weird.
That's what it's all about. How good was that timing, man?
It's pathetic.
It's fucking bright, man.
Well, saying I can't get control of that at all.
Like, is it?
It's so
far. I'm the man.
Anyway. I'm the man!
Well, that's just totally distorted. Right, so you actually performed last night as well?
Aye, I did. I played Weller Man. Everybody was singing, joining in, and then I played my new song, Ring Ding.
Ring Ding.
The Scotsman story, I love it.
So who were you up against, by the way? Did you know who?
I don't actually know, no.
Did you just give you it?
Aye, pretty much, aye. Probably because there was nobody else wanted it.
Well, I'm just thinking that we've actually, two of us have just moved house, so our invite for the show must have got lost in the post.
I get invited, just didn't know where to go.
Is that right? Don't know what happened to the invites, but wee bit of investigation, we'll see what happens. Not bitter at all, do you know what I mean?
No,
we'll see what happens. Class. So, you've been all over the shop.
Yes.
You have been all over the shop. I think for the last, I said, people aren't going to see the last podcast. But
I know.
It was fucking the best podcast
ever
recorded. It
was,
wasn't it? So let's just try and take some bits off the last last pod. Obviously, people know you're from TikTok.
Yes.
That was the main thing. So I don't know if everybody does know, but we talked about it last time. And obviously, we talked about the first time we met you. It's like, how did that kick off? And it was from someone just leaving a random comment on one of your videos about why don't you cover Weller Man?
And I thought, I just sat there, I was like, oh,
That's what happened. You stroked your fake moustache.
I had this on.
You did, I know.
I need to ass off. I'll put it in my chin. Keeps getting stuck to me. I'll just wear it
like that. Aye, wear it like that.
Superb.
So you did the comment, and went, aye. Okay, I'll do it. And then bang.
That was it, and then bang. Upload the video on the 27th of December, and then say by, I don't know, 10th of January, it was fully fledged single.
That's fucking mental, actually. So see when you, like, tell us this on TikTok, who's DM'd you? MD Big on TikTok?
On TikTok?
Or Instagram? Has MD hit you up?
Must be some...
Has MD slid into Nathan Evans' DMs?
I don't know, man, Nedy. I don't know.
There must be something.
You. You don't count.
you don't count.
Shite.
I swear to God, see, I'm going to fling that thing at the fucking window. Man. I mean, swear to God.
I don't really know, but... Obviously, at the time, Brian May, he duetted the video. So
Brian May?
Fucking brilliant!
Brian May?
Aye, Brian May, aye.
That is cool, isn't it?
Aye, so Brian May duetted it, Sir Andrew Lloyd Webber duetted it, Ronan Keaton and Gary Barlow, they duetted it as well. So aye, quite a lot of people. And then after the back of that, it was on the Ant Deck.
Aye, that's because we're fucking...
Mental.
Did we... Obviously, you come into your studio and you're at the following Smash Hit Told You So, which is number one in the European charts.
Just
is that
know.
Right?
Yes.
Mike Lima, represent. But I don't know, did you do Saturday Night Takeaway when we had met you? I think it was that week, was it? No?
I think. Oh,
no, it, maybe
2 weeks after. It was two weeks after. Because I remember watching it. And then, because you said that, like, because they were in a COVID kind of. Workplace, whatever.
Exactly.
Neither do you stand in the day selling that deck.
Right. So what I'll do is, and do you know what I'll do? I'm going to run through some stuff, obviously your story and all that, and see the end of it. I'm going to name names that people you've met.
Right.
And you're going to, it's shite or all right. So I'll say somebody and you'll go, ah, he's all right. Somebody, you go, ah, he's fucking shite. He's diarrhea, we use on Hans. That's what you'll say, right? So we'll recap.
It's a pirate, Greg. It takes all my pattern passes.
Shite.
Right.
Honestly, it's very good.
I don't know what that one is. Press it.
Press it. Fun out.
Oh, I know what it is.
Do you?
I know what it is. If you say something a bit daft, I'll press that.
Right, okay.
Right, okay. Right, press it all the time then.
Right, press that. All right, here we go.
Fucking brilliant!
Right, so move on. Right, so you do it. It's basically, it's just snowballs from putting the song out, Bill and Ted remix, bam, bam, bam. How long did it take to get to number one?
It was a few weeks. I don't know exactly how many weeks, but it was a good few weeks because we were climbing and climbing. Made in the top 10, made in the top 5, and then we sat at number 2 for, I don't know, about 4 weeks or something. And
At that time, you were number 1 in Germany, that, weren't you?
Aye.
Number 1 in Germany, Netherlands,
aye.
Switzerland. That's mental.
And I just couldn't break past number 1 because driver's license was keeping me off.
Good song, but
that's an absolute tune,
man. That's a good song.
But I can remember talking to you when you came to the studio and you said, we were just talking about how's it been, and this is the first time we met you, and you went, I think I'm going to be number 1 Sunday. And I was like, man, that's just, I couldn't get my head around that. It's like just sitting like, just normal, having a laugh, and then like knowing you were going to get to number 1.
Number 1 this week.
Yeah. It's a real deal, man.
It is class.
Knows what to do. What to
see
say.
See the wee number 1 things you give you, or the chart, is it real gold? I think it is.
No,
real,
silver it is. Silver
I think gold's album.
I have
gold
album.
Gold album. Oh, so gold.
But I don't know if it is actually real. It's no real silver today.
Well, Youngblood, well, he melted his, didn't he? To give it, like, he made it into wee pendants for his fans.
Did
he? If I just gave it away.
I think he did, but didn't he?
I think you didn't do that.
I think if
that's solid.
He's just made it, like, I don't know, alloy.
If that's real gold, that's a lot of money, because it's a big chunk. So you still know. So basically from then, you've got...
But a wee insider.
Right, okay, this is what
see,
it's all
so
about.
So when they send you a first one, it's obviously, you know, you find out before you get number one. Like, I found out, like...
So you have to act surprised. Oh, it's me, number 1.
That is banging out, innit?
And you've already known.
UK charts, sort it out.
Somebody's probably going to tell me that for this, but...
I don't give a fuck, man. Only exclusives in this podcast, right?
Maybe the only number 1 I get, so hey. I'm telling everybody.
That's it, hot, juicy gossip.
So... They send you a dummy one. Like, see your reward thing. They send you a dummy one with no printing on it. Nothing.
Is that right?
So they send you that one out. You take a picture with that. Then
you send it back?
Because you never know. It might change before. So that's like a if you get number one.
So hold on. Oh,
so you might be in like fucking.
So hold on. So do you know what I mean? Olivia Rodrigo could maybe have one, and you could have one, and whoever's won on the day.
Pretty much, aye, because it could still change up until like the Sunday. So they sent me
so
that.
They just, they've sent you. They've literally sent you a dummy because you could be having that and then no make it. Is that right? Disgrace, man.
Imagine you post a picture though. You post a picture and you're no number one, but you've no checked in, so you just think you've got number one. You post
the
it.
Game away.
That'd be hilarious. I'm number one. No, you're no. No, you're no.
Sure.
So that's a good bit of insider knowledge. That's fucking crazy. So, but you pretty much did know going into that week that you were going to be there or thereabouts, pretty much.
Aye. Well, I was number two at the time, and I knew. Like, obviously, you can see the streaming numbers, and I'm watching everything, and it was getting closer and closer every week. It was, like, at one point, she was double in front of me. Like, I think I was, like, say it was, like, 20, 30,000 in front of number three.
Right.
She was, whatever I was, double. So she was me twice, do you know what I mean? So there was, at one point, there was absolutely no danger, and then throughout the weeks,
so
it started to come down and down.
So is it sat, when is it you know that it's close?
What day? I think it was the Thursday or the Friday.
She's pulled out your credit card and bought a ton.
I was like, yes, let's go.
No, but that is fucking mental, man. Right. So, and then did you go to number two and then back to number one again? Is that right?
Aye.
Fucking hell, man.
We went to number two and I thought that was it. And then I think, if I remember right, we were number one and then the week of Ant and Dec, we dropped to number two. And then after that in deck, it went back up to number one again.
So what did you do to celebrate? That's what I want to know.
Absolutely nothing.
What?
it's still COVID time.
It's still COVID, so I couldn't do it.
Oh, you're joking?
Nah.
Sat you got a hoagie, didn't you?
I got a hoagie, man. Sat in my mum and dad's living room and I ate a hoagie.
There you go. There you go. Every single person that thinks, oh, number one, he's at party, he's at trash in the places, oh, Dells and you know, TV's in the windy. Cool. He's fucking sitting there eating a hoagie.
Eating a hoagie, mate.
Sake, man.
And actually, I bought a £6 bottle of champagne. So I could toss
did
it.
You?
So just so I could do that with man. I was like buzzing and then I wasted it and went back in, had a beer. That was me.
So you're leading me to the next question.
Yes.
You get number one.
Yes.
What's an item you treat yourself to after that?
Oh, fucking, we know that. Okay. Every time he comes in, he's got a new pair of shoes on.
Aye.
But that's what I'm saying, but just in case you get number one, say, well, I'll fancy buying this now.
I can't even remember. I think I'd bought the card before.
Ah, you definitely did. You fucking you can hear that from about 2 miles away.
Aye, you know what I mean? It's got a big exhaust.
But I think it was just trainers, I think.
Do you know buy a new guitar?
No, it's freebies.
I did buy that guitar.
There you
actually.
Go, see?
I did buy that guitar.
There you go.
Aye, I've no gift that guitar yet, by the
way. Is that right?
Outrageous. Taylor, if you're watching.
There you go.
I've been gifted.
Wait, what?
What?
Wait, what?
Fenders? God's gift.
Fenders everywhere.
I get gifted Fenders.
You get fuck all. You get discount. I get gifted, you get discount.
Drums are the worst, man. Levels. Drums are the worst. Don't get anything for
basically,
free.
Basically, a couple of years ago, Fender went, listen, what to sponsor you. So I got 2 amps, 3 guitars, leads, pedals, all the rest of it.
Sold he every
get,
single
he
bit
he
of
he
it.
He get jealous. And he's
at... He got a 30% off discount code.
He did, he get 30% off.
That's shocking. Sold every bit of Stevie's Fender stuff and pocketed all the cash.
No, he didn't. He set one amp.
He's reaching that one.
Because I rinsed. You know what I mean? We set an amp.
What?
Sorry, Fender.
I had to.
Aye.
Took any money.
Pocket the cash.
No money. We don't get number ones. You know what I mean?
So see when you get asked to do the Brits.
Yes.
I get asked to do the Brits and you're doing, was it Jack Whitehall was
aye.
On that?
Aye, Big Jack.
Bang. What was that like?
Mental, man. Absolutely incredible. So
Jack Whitehall. Who else did you meet then in the green room and behind the scenes and that?
Again, that was COVID, so it was very, very strict, man. Aye.
Right,
So I never really met anybody. Obviously, I met Jack Whitehall and stuff, but when I was doing my performance, like, we walked down by where all the celebrities and all the artists were sitting.
Yeah.
So, like, could see Little Mix. Heady One was sitting there as well. And then when we got to the line,
see,
all the was like the...
Is Capaldi there?
No, he wasn't sitting with everybody, so I don't know if he just came into these better, but I don't know.
He just stormed on.
Stormed on.
Mic drop, then fucked off,
that
didn't
was it? Away he went, man.
Class.
Did he have a bottle of wine with him that time?
Yeah, a bottle of bucket,
straight on. So see if that ever happens to me, whenever, if I'm getting a big award like that, I just walk home with a hoagie.
Walk on with hoagie.
You know what I mean?
Use a hoagie as a mic.
Fucking
brilliant!
Fucking go for it, man. Know what I mean? Everybody knows what a hoagie is, by the way. There could be folk going, what the fuck's a hoagie?
That's true, man.
Well, you need to come to Scotland and find it.
Aye.
Simple as that.
It's a big juicy wrap.
Excuse me, they're all sitting watching the computer. You can fucking Google it.
See, when you go to the Brits and that, do you... See when you're taking a shite at the Brits?
Aye.
Was it like, the toilet's good?
Well, I had mine in my room, so...
Was it alright,
man?
Aye.
Well,
did you have a toilet in your room?
I like to judge...
In your dressing room, like, I'm looking at, see the MTV EMAs, they've got petitions up. That's what I was imagining.
Cubicles, like a festival.
Like, remember, like, in Quebec, it was petitions, like black curtains.
Oh, yeah, that's
it was up. Oh, that's what I was picturing. I was picturing it like that. And I was going to toilet like in there.
An actual dressing room thing.
Oh, yeah, that's
what I like.
Sorry, mate.
I like to judge that when I'm going to venues.
Aye.
I've got this wee system in my head that I mark venues, how good they are, like, in terms of... Like the stage is, how good the dressing room is, how good the toilet is, how good like the rider, the staff and all the rest of it.
Aye.
And one of the big things is, because as you know,
the shiter is.
I've got celiac. I don't know if anybody knows that. I'm gluten free. Right.
You can geez that. Press one. Shite. There you go. Right. Thanks very much.
So, sometimes I just need to go. I just go for it. And I genuinely mark the venues out on how good the
skid mark them.
So there's been some absolute belters, but there's been absolute, like...
Oh, there's been dreadful toilets, man.
Everything's been great. Superb. Staff are nice. Stage is great. And the toilet is just like an abomination. I'm thinking, I'm never playing this place again.
Do you know, it was terrible, right? See, you've got to go and play Europe, right? But we'll come on to that. But there's a... What was the venue we played in Paris?
Well, Maronique.
No, the headline one.
Supersonic. Stunk of shite.
No, because of me. Because of me.
No, it was Gourmet a Sausage.
Oh, no, the thing we want headlines to.
Gourmet a Sausage.
We're into the toilet. You ever try to do a shite but half your 2 feet up against the door? Because there's no lock.
Oh, was that way?
That's what I had to do.
That was a universal toilet at with Arizona.
What the fuck?
No, the one the headline to. I can't remember the name of the venue. And it was like unisex toilets, right?
Right.
And I thought, oh, man, I can't have anybody walking in me doing a shite. So the lock was broke. So I had to do a shite with my two legs pressed against the door, then a leg press against the door, man. Stunk the place out. And then everybody was complaining.
What did he say?
Right, next. Next.
No, but...
Next, going to the next.
Anyway, I know. I don't know why you're saying that, man.
Sorry, just embarrassed my full family.
But, no, it's like, it's interesting because I just like to know, like, obviously, people think backstage and that is fucking all guts and glamour, but sometimes it's no. Sometimes you get put in stuff that's absolutely...
No, but hold the bus, there's levels. Nathan's like top tier.
Yeah, you are in top tier.
We're bottom shite.
No, we've mid-tier. Been bottom. We're mid-tier.
Aye.
We're championship.
Mid-table.
We're mid-table, aye.
We're the championship looking for promotion. That's what we're for. We're fighting out with Norwich, fucking Bournemouth and all the rest.
And I'm like Leicester that time they won the league.
Aye.
Just showed up like Leicester.
No, because that's the thing.
Just battered it.
It's
Jamie
like
Vardy.
You get different levels, that's what I'm saying. So if you were, I mean, we've been in with name drop, you've been with like Youngblood and Capaldi, they've got decent dressing rooms, right? When you're the support band, you get flunged in the bottom. Do you know what I mean? So you're out in the hallways or you're actually in the toilet, that's your dressing room. Do you know what I mean?
One time we played a place in Sheffield called the Boardwalk, right? And we were in a Witherspoons.
We were in a Witherspoons, right?
And we were having, you know, you get a pint and a burger or something. And somebody goes downstairs for the toilet and comes up and goes, guys, you need to go downstairs and see that shite somebody's took, right? We walked downstairs, right? You ever seen Still Game with Innes where he sits and starts him, right? But it had a peanut stuck in it. So the peanut was like, and it was like a crease in the jobby and a piece and a peanut was an eye. So it looked like you walked down
I'm telling you, it was like a bit of wood. It was a chunk of wood, right? And then that wall just winking at you, and I thought, oh my god.
We've been talking about shite for a minute.
Oh, sorry.
What time are we on? 10 minutes left?
12 minutes,
right, okay. So what was after that? So you did fucking, after the Brits, you're number one in Jeremy 10 weeks in a row.
Yes.
11.
Then
11.
11 weeks. 11. Then you jump into the studio. Then you write in the studio and you write an absolute banger with your best rose. And we released that. When was that, June?
June. End of June. 25th of June.
Because that's fucking. Because basically you've done all of that.
Remember everything?
You've done all of that, and then next minute it's like bang. COVID's kind of taking a break. So you're number one, and you're in a new tune.
Right.
Festivals and all the rest that she did. Transmit. Where was that place you played?
Done Relight Festival. Done Wickham Festival. I went out to Switzerland, done Energy Air over there in front of 40,000 people, which was ridiculous.
Fucking brilliant!
That is amazing.
That is brilliant. What else did I do? I done a few things in Germany.
What was the name of that stadium?
So the name of Young Boys Stadium, Young Boys,
yeah,
Wanked Off.
What did he say?
Exactly.
Wanked
off. Label. Whoever's thought of that is an
wanked
absolute
young
idiot.
Boys. Wanked off, young that boys. That is ridiculous. I really hope my granny doesn't watch this podcast. She's going to be raging.
She shout out, it. Granny B.
Do you get a jazz? Do them to give you any flack for... You don't really swear and stuff, or they crazy stuff, do you?
Nah.
You kind of just chill.
Sometimes, like, see if I spend... Like, see if there's a time where I'm no in London and I'm no... Like, if I'm not in Germany or whatever, and I spend loads of time with my pals, or talking to Holly, or talking to family and all that. See, whenever I do go back to London, I'm always fuck, shite, fuck all the time.
Aye, but that's I'm like, oh, that's part of being Scottish.
Cut out, man. I know.
You're doing that. What are you TikTok now, follower wise?
1.4 million.
1.4, stick that in your basket. Oh, I love
one
it.
Point, you, I know exactly what you're going to say there.
I know.
And you couldn't say it.
I know.
I know exactly what you were going to say.
I
caught that.
And if you said what I know you say, then this podcast would have been over.
Cancelled, finished.
It's not that.
But it's not cancelled. It was just, no, my gran would have... My gran
would have killed me.
Exactly.
My gran and my mum would have absolutely...
It would have been over.
Poor Granny B sitting on edge watching
him.
This.
Love it. Aye, because my gran's dead proud. Because seeing her doing stuff like she's...
Thank God you said proud after it.
What's that?
My gran's dead.
No, she's dead proud. I know.
My gran's dead proud.
No, but she's like, anytime you'll be the same with your mum and dad and your family. Anytime you hear a song or anytime something happens, they phone you and say, I've heard it on the radio, heard it on, seen it on TV. So, our gran watches everything.
Aye.
So, if we swear or that, she's fucking
on it.
Right, fucking on us, man. Every 2 minutes, fucking does my box in, man.
I'm pleasure at the start of this. We said we're going to try and keep this child friendly.
I know.
You say that. I know. He's
in the bin.
I'm going to be beating like fuck.
my granda phoned me actually on the way here to this.
What did he say?
It was just talking about last night at the awards. But like you said, they phone all the time. My dad phones me. My mum phones me. Granda phones me.
His dad's Davy Evans. That's what
my dad's Davy.
Dad Davy
so
Evans.
The
he's got a brother called Glenn.
There you go.
Glenn Evans.
There you go.
Glenn Evans, man, that sounds beautiful, doesn't it?
Glenn Simmons, his name is.
Glenn Simmons.
For fuck's
mate,
sake.
Family Trees.
Wikipedia is fucking shite, by the way.
Family Trees running wild, man.
Aye. Family Trees not a clue, man. Family Forest.
Forest Furnishings.
Like, press.
Shite.
Thanks.
Sorry about that.
The keys weren't it?
Right, so that, right, okay, so I'm just trying to round up here. Because obviously we've tried to format this to get 30 minutes. So it is just the best insider knowledge, best gossip you can get, which we have provided.
Yes.
Which is fantastic. Tell us what you're up to next.
Going in tour.
I'll give you a couple of minutes to promote yourself. On you go.
Right, okay. Don't listen, you stuff.
There you go.
Going in tour. In December, UK tour, going to Glasgow twice, Edinburgh, going to Aberdeen, going to Coventry, going to London, going to Manchester, going to Milton Keynes, going to Dublin as well. So if you want tickets are on
and
sale.
And then where are you going after that?
And then after that, I'm going to Europe in January. Going to Germany 4 times, going to Lithuania, Estonia, France, Finland, where else?
Phileas Fogg over here in the world.
There's a few more places. I'm right. Playing 17 dates in Europe.
Where can you get tickets?
Nathan Evans.
In all my bios. So if you're following me on Instagram or Facebook or Twitter or whatever it is, in there is the link. If no, if you go to Ticketmaster or is it Songkick?
Songkick.
Just when you're saying this in all your bios, do you ever get fucking sick of doing social media? Like, I can't be fucked with this.
Aye.
All the time.
Aye.
I'm the same.
Because... the thing is, when you're on the phone, you're kind of working. So,
aye, people say you're on your phone. I'm like, well, I'm working.
Aye, exactly. Aye. Like my dad always says to me, he's like, "Do you ever get sick of that and being your own?" And I'm like, "I'm filling out an email." Do you know what I mean? Aye. Or I'm just replying to somebody.
Aye, but that's the thing. It's like people don't get.
I'm not just sitting.
It's part and parcel of the job that you have to also the TikTok, you have to watch TikTok to see what's
which new and which trending.
And you can try. Yeah, exactly. It's brain frying. I saw
a thing. You had a question by who? I don't know. You probably don't want to answer this, right? But your dad's probably the same height as you.
Bigger? No, he's smaller.
Is he?
Aye.
Who'd win a square go? Who your dad?
Me and he's old.
Oh, there you go. Davey.
And I'm taller.
Davey with the scrap.
And if I can't beat him, man, I'll just hit me, son.
So you maybe talk about shite and debattering your dad.
I know he's going to watch us. I'm getting smashed on a game, man.
Out there, everybody that you have, because we touched on it, obviously, the last podcast, that the greatest podcast that nobody's ever going to see. You played football last week in the Soccer 6.
Yes.
Al played, scored
still
four
waiting,
goals.
Still waiting
on
Nathan Passon.
Who
a week ago, and he's still no shot because I never passed in the ball.
Who's the soundest guy you've met in music?
Or Girl.
Aye, that's pardon me. Hey guys.
Shite.
My bad. Right, I'm really sorry about that. Everybody's equal, and I didn't mean that. When I said guys, what did I say, guy?
Guy.
Have you seen me say hey guys? You mean like girls and guys, or well, you collectively say guys for everybody?
Right.
Greg's doing that.
Right.
Fuck's sake, Greg.
Shite.
But what I'm saying is, who's the soundest person that you have met in music?
Fucking brilliant.
Saved it.
I don't know what the soundest is. Obviously used to, you know what I mean? And I'm not just saying that.
We are up there.
Know what I mean?
G4 claims.
But there hasn't been anybody that I've met that I've thought...
Dick,
aye. There is nobody I've met that I've just went...
Oh, you've been lucky. I've met a few hurlers, man.
We've not really met anybody that's been arsehole.
Oh, tons of them.
Name and shame.
Tons of them. Right, okay.
Oh!
Getting on Hidges all hook, line, and sinker. We only meet sound people.
We have been actually very, very
we
lucky.
We don't talk to idiots.
Yeah, we've actually been very, very sound and very lucky that we haven't actually met MD that's a complete arse. Right. Everybody's been absolutely brand new.
And everybody is they're all in the same boat, they're all wanting the same thing, they're all doing the same thing, so they all relate and aye.
Well, listen, I spoke to name dropping, but Kieran out of Circa Waves, we were writing a song with him, and he was saying he was away touring with Jerry Cinnamon and all the rest of it, and he's just saying everybody's sound. He said, I've not really come up with MD, met MD that's been an arsehole, and I said, well, we're the same kind of lucky.
No.
Let me finish my story.
Sorry, I've got one person just popped in my head there. That's fine. I'll name and shame after,
wait,
sorry.
Let me finish then.
Hurry up.
But he says, we went into the 1975 right at the start, and they were doing all this stuff. They're pulling me backing track, and I was like, I don't know if it's my thing and all the rest of it. And then I realised they're just trying to do their thing. Everybody's just trying to do their thing and be the best they can be in music, whatever that is, and just try to be them, try and do something different, make them distinctive. And I guess that's what you've got to just... You just do the same as we're doing TikToks and doing Scottish words. It's like, well, we're just doing something that works, you know what I mean?
Exactly.
It's like, so I think you get that bit of perspective when you're looking at other acts and other people. So, well, they're just trying to do their thing. They're just doing it because they want to be successful. Do you know what I mean?
Exactly.
Right, go.
I've got it. Tell you.
Don't get us in trouble.
Nah. He's straight top list of Al's big brown jobby book.
Who?
NF.
NF.
Remember NF? We supported NF.
The guy called NF.
Wow.
American rapper. Really good.
Some rapper taste.
Actually quite excited by him. Played Camden Assembly. Got down there. We just chapped his dressing room. Like, we just stayed away from him the whole time. Been very respectful. Just chapped his door to give him some. Like, I think we got a bottle or something or whatever. And just said, thank you very much for this opportunity. Like we always do when we get a support act. And I think the main thing is probably Al asked him for a picture.
I said, listen, any chance get a quick picture? And he went, nah.
He went, nah, man. He said, nah, man, don't do that.
And I said, what? Who? Where is he?
That's what he said. He said, nah, man, don't do that, man.
Terrible accent. No, I just said, he said, nah. And I just looked and I thought, oh, I think he's kidding. And I was like, oh, okay.
He's
at no pictures. And then just shut the door.
All right, that was it.
That was the only experience with asshole.
Yeah.
What a tosser.
So there you go. Well, he's top of the list in the jobby book.
Right, that's fine.
Right, okay.
Got slap, it on my chest. Slap that ass.
Yeah.
So, I think, are we 30 minutes?
2 minutes.
2 minutes? How come that's at 29?
I don't know.
The clocks don't
compute. Because you were talking, we've done a wee speech at the start first.
Oh, by the way, just to say, I was going to say something, I can't remember. It was like the phone thing, that was just when we're finishing off here. On the phone thing, I read something saying that because people are on their phone more, they're getting less and less emotionally involved. Or just emotional because they're getting switched off, and you're seeing all this thing about people becoming cyborgs and all the rest of it. It's crazy, isn't it, man?
What did he say?
You know what I mean?
Right, I know you need a minute, like, a minute to fill the space, but right,
what we're going to do now, everybody, it was great to see Nathan, and we're going to round this off with some questions, Nathan.
Okay. So, for anyone watching, last week I thought, we'll get cards made. There's nothing on these cards.
Yeah, cards are blank.
Because I've not had time to do it. Right, so, here we go, Nathan. Quick fire.
Okay, let's go.
Okay. Do it again. One more time.
Okay, let's go.
Right, here we go, Nate.
G4 claims.
Right, here we
by the way, just to say, if you ever in a road traffic accident, G4 claims is the way to go.
And also, check out Mile Signs. For all your signage needs. Anyway, right, okay, here we go. Here we go, Nate
there,
Dog. Quick fire.
We're there, man. Take a series here.
Yeah, let's go. Quick fire.
Right, go.
Right, ready? I'm
ready.
Right, okay, here we go. If you had to choose never having sex or never playing live again, what would it be?
Never playing live again. Mate, I know, but hey, social media. Know what I mean?
Big man loves his hole.
Okay.
What can you do?
Finger or thumb?
Oh. Whereabouts?
What did he say?
It's quickfire. Quickfire. Finger thumb. Or thumb. Oof.
Ooh.
Oh, naughty boy. Right, ketchup or brown sauce?
Ketchup.
Don't football or music?
It's got to be music. That hurts, man. It hurts to say, but it needs to be.
Most famous person's number in your phone?
Luis Capaldi. it might not even be his number, right enough. Might not even be his.
He changes it quite a lot.
Oh,
that's all right. Don't worry, we're still going.
Still going.
Right. Who's the most famous number in your
my phone?
Quick fire back at you, mate.
A young brother, Capaldi. Nice. Capaldi.
Capaldi.
Nice.
Capaldi.
What about you?
I don't know if Ali McCoy's more famous than Luis Capaldi. For me, he is. Mm. I would say Capaldi, young bud. I've got a couple of others, I'm trying to think. Decent ones.
I've got a few, but
he's got that many, he needs to think about it. I'm only saying Capaldi because that's all I've got.
Joe Biden. Right, next one, right?
Right, go.
Have you ever received a nude photo?
Yes.
Fucking brilliant! Right, whose music do you absolutely hate?
So last time I said Slipknot.
Aye.
Like on the best podcast you'll ever see.
Shiny.
just because I don't like heavy metal, so we're going to go with Slipknot again.
And I swear to you again. So Slipknot, if you're listening, if you're watching this podcast, Nathan Evans says your music is
suck
shite.
On these nuts.
As if they care.
I know. Do you wipe front to back or back to front?
Front to back, come on. You can't be that. Going for back to front.
I don't know.
Weird.
Does anybody actually wipe back to front?
Does anybody actually wipe?
Is that where the name Shitnuts comes from?
Shit. What?
Like he calls somebody shit nuts? Is that because somebody's wiping
back? I have never
back?
In my life I've called someone shit nuts. Have you called anyone shit nuts?
Oh, tons of.
Shit nuts.
Yeah.
When is that?
I think that's what happened. Jolly boys.
Shite.
Right, next.
Have you ever been caught masturbating?
No.
Fucking brilliant.
I have, you dirty dog.
I don't like them.
Chinese food or Indian food?
Man, we're talking about hoagies or podcasts, so it needs to be Indian dinner.
Oh, there you go. Pizza Hut or Domino's?
They're both the same. Pizza Hut. I don't know.
Oh, right, that's fair. Pineapple on a pizza?
No. Grow up.
Shite.
Wait, do you miss six?
I disagree, man. I have pineapple on a pizza.
No, man.
The only thing I'd say does not deserve to be on a pizza is tuna. I've seen people have tuna pizzas.
That's
ridiculous.
Get in jail. Stinking.
Get in the bin.
Do you regret getting
your calf tattooed?
No, I do not. No. Fucking come off, innit?
Right. Favourite member of One Direction?
Harry Styles.
And that's it.
Fucking
brilliant!
There you go.
Ladies and gentlemen, everybody,
it's great to see you!
It's been great to see you!